Harry Potter was a highly unusual boy in many ways. For one thing, he hated the summer holidays more than any other time of year. For another, he really wanted to do his homework, but was forced to do it in secret, in the dead of night. And he also happened to be a wizard. It was nearly midnight, and he was lying on his front in bed, the blanket drawn right over his head like a tent, a torch in one hand, and a large leather-bound book, A History of Magic by Bathilda Bagshot, propped open against the pillow. Harry moved the tip of his eagle feather quill down the page, frowning as he looked for something that would help him write his essay, which burning in the 14th century was completely pointless. Discuss. The quill paused at the top of a likely-looking paragraph. Harry pushed his round glasses up his nose, moved his torch closer to the book, and read. Non-magic people, more commonly known as muggles, were particularly afraid of magic in medieval times, but not very good at recognizing it. On the rare occasion that they did catch a real witch or wizard, burning had no effect whatsoever. The witch or wizard would perform a basic flame freezing charm, and then pretending to shriek with pain while enjoying a gentle tickling sensation. Indeed, Wendelin the White enjoyed being burned so much that she allowed herself to be caught no fewer than 47 times in various disguises.